can't miss the funeral. Hey, hey, got the juice, money got me chasing. Got the coupe, walk the roof is missing.
Round two.
Let's try this kitchen and bathroom cleaning brush. I love it. So today I'm using the VacLife vacuum to clean my car. As you can see, it comes with multiple attachments and has an LED light. I take my dog out a lot, hence the pet hair, so I really wanted something to pick it up easy, and this was perfect. Now the boot was the worst place for the hair. I don't really think the video does it any justice, but as you can see, it picks it up nice and easy. The vacuum is cordless, lightweight, and just so convenient for car use.
Need a new obsession? Welcome to the oh-so-satisfying world of Clean Talk. Fall down that rabbit hole to tips, tricks, and hacks that make Clean Talk such a mesmerizing place.
Thank you. How long does it take a person to clean up?
Before we came home from vacation, we made sure to give the house we stayed at a very deep clean so the people who so graciously let us stay there would come back to a spotless home. This is a little bit longer cleaning than normal, but I hope you enjoy.
This is the grave of Fred Walter Oatman. On some documents, his name is Walter Fred, and on others, he's Fred Walter. So I'm going to go by what's on his grave. I knew right away that this grave was really going to try my patience in terms of waiting for a transformation, but I was not disappointed. Fred was born on November 4th, 1857. He was the third child of Isaac and Charlotte Oatman. They had 8 children in all: Orlin, Isaac, Fred, Lucy, Elijah, Lottie, Lydia, and George. George died in 1854 at the age of 3, but the rest of the children lived at least into early adulthood. One interesting thing I found about Fred's family: in 1870, Fred and all of his siblings, who ranged in age from 18 all the way down to 1 month, were living in Hebron, New York, with a couple named Samuel and Eliza Huggins. Their parents were living together, but completely separate from the children, but still in the same town. I couldn't find anything to directly explain that. Isaac did work, and they owned real estate and did have some finances, so it doesn't seem like poverty was the issue. But whatever reason, they at that time weren't capable of taking care of their children. By the next census in 1880, Isaac and Charlotte were living with their children that were still young enough to live at home. In August 1877, Fred died at the age of 19. His grave says 20, but he was actually just a couple months shy of turning 20. His cause of death was dropsy. If you follow me, you've heard that word a lot. Dropsy is an antiquated medical term for edema or swelling, usually caused by heart, liver, or lung failure. Just 5 years after Fred died, his sister Lucy died of scarlet fever at the age of 22, and she's buried just next to Fred. Fred's inscription says, "We miss thee at home." The top of his grave has a banner that says, "Our boy." I'll show it at the end. Here's the transformation after just a couple months. Here's the detail on the top.
Enjoy this satisfying backyard, please.
Hold me closer, hold me fast, this magic spell you cast.
This is what happens when daddy watches the kids.
When you kiss me, heaven sighs, and though I close my eyes, I see la vie en rose. When you press me to your heart, I'm in a world apart. A world of roses bloom. And when you speak, angels sing from above. Every day words seem to turn into love songs. Give your heart and soul to me, and life will always be lovely.
Powerful to clean inside. Cleaning my wax warmer.
I haven't made my mind up, should I keep it? I got big dogs, that is the name of secret.